I'm in Brookwell Park here in London. I want to do a quick video on what it's like to get published. So getting published, I got recently published in End Photo Magazine, which is like a Nikon consumer magazine that you can buy in supermarkets and stuff. I thought I'd tell you about it because I get published often enough and not sound big-headed. But, should look there, that's where my camera is. But I thought I'd just give you some tips because people do ask me how they get published. So one of the greatest tips you can do is actually do the donkey work yourself, which is to go in, buy magazines, particularly support the magazines you want to be published in. Go into the supermarket wherever you buy magazines, and editors' email addresses are often listed two or three pages in. Contact them, check their Instagram, find out how you submit. Jury's out for me on whether you should pay to submit your work. I know there's a lot of fan like websites and stuff that say it, and then they don't give you a free copy and you just pay like to be considered. And I think the most I've seen is $15 to be considered. That's per image. And then you have to buy the magazine, and it's not in actual circulation. It's like one that people can pay for and they'll do a print copy, which is always a bit weird for me, but fine. I've never had to pay to submit any of my work. I've either been approached to have my work or I've submitted it. Often there's like a call for works so that goes through. It's really good if you can get an article as well, which is what Envo did this month for me. They put an article in what I'd written alongside my imagery. That was really cool. Top tip, credit everyone in your team. And I think that's a really good thing. Not only do they then share it themselves because they're really proud and that gives your name out more, but also it's just an etiquette thing because that image doesn't happen without that talent. So when you go to submit, make sure the work you're submitting actually fits in with the magazine you're submitting it to. So there's no point in sending all women's wear to a men's only wear magazine. Shoot what you think would go in there, but also perhaps give them something a little different to whet their appetite. I found that if you shoot just basic portrait and send it off to a portrait, they've seen hundreds of these. Do something that makes you stand out a little bit. So that helped. Submit timely. Don't just send like massive files to publishers. Actually perhaps prepare a link that they can go to have a look at your work, or ask them how you go about submitting it. I'm not into these people who submit like massive amount of work. Like some people send me work for me to critique and it's like this huge file, and I'm just like, I'm not even opening that, it's just ridiculous. Or I get a warning saying it's a huge file, I don't want to do that. There is JPEGs if anything, if you really want to send. Give them something that will inspire them. One thing I found out though is if a magazine asks for exclusive rights, actually tie them down to when they're planning on publishing, because I had one magazine keep my work for over a year with exclusive rights and I had other magazines wanting to publish it, and in the end I had to say to them, you've had it for over a year, you've not published it. And then, oh, it's because we were waiting for this and then we missed it, and then I was like, no, I'll just take it back off you, it's fine, thank you. And I got it published twice elsewhere and was paid. No, not all your work that you get published is paid for. Bizarrely, it's a thing in the industry. It happens. I'm not really sure what the answer is, because people always submit their work for free to get the name out there. I do know that when I submitted a couple bits for free, I did actually get paid work from it. So it's, you know, put it out there to get it back, I guess. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon.